What's up, everyone? Today I'm here with Dustin Luke. I'm sure you know who he is. He is the most Argentinian American, does that make sense, that you'll ever probably meet in your life. He speaks incredible Spanish, and I'm super excited to be here chatting with him today about Argentina. And yeah, so thanks for being here.
Nate, man, un placer. Un placer estar acá. I came with my dos banderas with me. Super excited about it. I just want to say, man, it's so refreshing and exciting to always connect with other gringos who you know, love the culture, love the movement. You know, there's nothing better than being in a room or in a place with a gringo or several gringos, whatever, that can just kind of interact and immerse themselves into a Spanish-speaking culture or environment. It's a kind of connection that you know, you don't get to build with that many people that often.
Sure. And,
so de nuevo, es un placer.
Yeah, igualmente.
The very first thing about Argentina that really grabbed my attention was the accent, right? And es el acento rioplatense. Mm-hmm. This accent comes from Buenos Aires, or most people who speak it in Argentina are from Buenos Aires.
Right.
Alrededores, uh-huh. Right? About a third of the country lives in Buenos Aires. So, like, unfortunately, if someone ever references an Argentine, they're speaking about, usually they're referencing someone from Buenos Aires. Uh-huh. So everyone in the country is always like, pero Buenos Aires no es solamente Argentina, somos todos. Like, tenemos Córdoba, tenemos Patagonia. Like, uh-huh. You'll always find that from another Argentine. So beware of that. I always reference the Porteño accent, the Rio Platense accent.
Sure.
You also find in, Uruguay, and you'll find it in southern parts of Argentina, etc.
Sure.
But that's what kind of grabbed my attention initially. You know, I'd never, you know, when you start to learn, you at first don't really know how to distinguish between different accents because you're not yet at that
right,
level. Most people in the States, we learn like 2 years in high school,
right,
and then we're not ever like to a level where we can be like Colombian, Chilean. And so once I finally kind of got to that level and I like saw the light, I started to explore the Argentinian accent, the Porteño accent, and
yeah.
I was like, it's amazing, me encanta.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, in general, I'm a very like passionate person and a very expressive. Like,
sure.
When I talk, I'll be like, yeah, like this happened, yeah. You know? Y los porteños son así. They're uh-huh. like, sí, boludo, no sabía lo que me pasó ayer, no estoy loco. Like, you know, they really, you know, their level of expression is on like, you know, a whole other level because they use their hands, they speak with their, you know, it's a very much of a like gestures and body language when you're interacting with Porteño. And I love that. I was excited about that when I heard that. And I was just like, you know what? I think this is what I'm going to adopt this accent. But
I don't know. I think it's so interesting how you had kind of like learned that style of Spanish, but then we're like, but I really like the Porteño accent. Like, I'm going to learn that. Because, like, I remember I was a TA in a native Spanish speakers class for them. I don't know, just so they could all keep speaking Spanish. I don't know. But there's one girl in the class who had the Porteño accent. And I was like, oh, my God. Like, every time she spoke, I just, like, fell in love with her. I was like, man, this accent is so cool. Like, so it's cool that you had, like, learned, like, a different accent, or I don't want to say neutral, but a different accent. And then you were like, man, I like this accent. And then you learn that. That's so cool.
Yeah. Yeah, it says a lot. I mean, I think it says a lot about Argentine culture in general. It's just a combination of something that I was completely oblivious about, you know, and having like kind of like dabbled into it. You know, I started to also like, most of my, you know, friends were like, dude, I love when Argentina speaks, like, I love it.
Yeah.
And like, I started to pick up on these different like trends and these ideas. And you know, I noticed that even like Latinas would say like, ah, me encanta el acento argentino, son creídos. And so I also, this is a personality thing, but I've always kind of been this person to do things that were like kind of different and kind of like stood out and kind of like wasn't the regular path. And I felt like this was so unique, this like cultura argentina. I mean, no one that I knew in my entire life had, like, unless they were Latino, they knew a little bit. Besides that, no one had a clue about Argentina. And I felt like it was just like, I found this Narnia that like no one had ever discovered. And it was just like, man, this is awesome, man. I felt like I was truly living, and like I into this new foreign place and come back with new perspectives and experiences.
Definitely. Yeah, I think that's something that we forget, like, about like the language is like, it, like you said, it's like, oh, you're like, this whole world has like been in front of me the whole time, but then like you kind of like, once you realize it's there, then you're like, whoa, this is, like you said, it's like Narnia. You're like, whoa, this is so weird. Like,
so awesome. If you roughly say about 50% of their earliest settlers, I guess you would say, were Italian.
Sure.
And therein lies the intonation. Therein lies this, like, this song, this cantito.
Yeah.
And obviously the gestures as well. You know, about 25% from Spain, and then about 25% roughly from Europe. Mm. Very little indigenous, and, you know, their powers combined. You have the Argentina.
Yeah.
And I love it, man. I've immersed myself so much in the culture that if I see an Argentine, like these days, if I run into an Argentine, I'm just like, vení acá, papá. So, you know, it's like it's a cool connection that, I'm really, really... you know, excited, and I feel privileged to have been able to kind of create for myself, because you know, they're amazing people. It's just a question of understanding.
Dustin, muchísimas gracias por hablarme hoy. Eres re amable, re argentino, y gracias por compartir tu conocimiento de Argentina y su cultura, y realmente eres súper genial. Entonces, gracias.
Hey, un placer estar acá, y como te dije antes, como conectarme con otros gringos que hablan español, que entienden la cultura, es un amigo mío. Así que gracias.
Pues gracias a ti. Y estamos hablando.
Listo.
Chao.